Consider the logic statement. X equals A and B, or C and not B, XOR not C. Draw a logic circuit to represent the given logic statement. Do not attempt to simplify the statement. All logic gates must have a maximum of 2 inputs. Alright, I've rewritten the logic statement over here. And the reason we've done this is so that we can simplify the logic statement. Alright, the first step we're going to do is to find the logic gate with the most brackets around it. So starting on the left-hand side, we're going to count the number of brackets around each logic gate and determine which one has the most brackets around it. Starting off with our AND gates, this has 3 total brackets. This OR gate only has 2 brackets. The AND and the NOT both have 3. And the XOR and the NOT only have 1. So we've got 3 options. We have this AND gate, we've got this AND gate, and we've got this NOT gate. Alright, when we have this, we're just going to go from left to right. So we'll start by drawing this AND gate. When drawing the AND gates, we want to make sure it's big enough so that the examiner doesn't mistake our logic gate for another logic gate. So let's go ahead and draw this AND gate. Alright, once we've connected the inputs to the left-hand side of our gate, we're going to give this a label of M. The reason why we give it a label of M is because M, N, P, and Q are all letters in the middle of the alphabet. The way I like to think of it is A, B, and C is on the left of the alphabet, X, Y, and Z for the outputs are on the right side of the alphabet, and the middle of the alphabet is our processors. This also helps us in simplifying our logic statement. So we're going to come to our logic statement, and we're going to replace A and B with M. Alright, so we're just going to write M over there. Once we've drawn the first logic gate, we're going to continue with our next logic gates. So go back to step 1 and count which gates have the most brackets around them. In this case, we have 2 options. We have the AND gate and the NOT gate. Whenever we have a NOT gate, we always choose the NOT gate first, because we simply cannot write this AND gate given 2 inputs C and NOT B. NOT B is undefined yet. So let's go ahead and draw our NOT gate. Once we've drawn the NOT gate, we're going to connect it up to its inputs. The input is B. Whenever we connect B, we usually want to notate this with a dot, just so that we can see that these 2 lines are joined. All right, and as before, we're going to give this a label of N. All right, and just like before, we're going to replace NOT B with N. All right, we've gotten to a stage now where there are no more gates that we can draw immediately. So we're going to bring all of our gates down that we haven't yet drawn. Let's bring down our brackets. We'll bring down the OR gates. We'll bring down C and. We'll bring down XOR and NOT C. All right, again, we're going to go back to our first step, which is to find the logic gate that has the most brackets around it. This is going to be the AND gate, because the AND gate has 3 brackets around it. Since we now have N as one of the inputs, we're going to use our logic gate, N, as the input to this AND gate, along with C. All right, we've drawn our AND gate. Let's draw the inputs. All right, and as before, we're going to give it a label. This time, we're going to label it P. You may be wondering why I've skipped out O. Well, because O looks a bit too similar to 0 or 1, which might get a bit confusing when we're speaking about binary. Again, let's label C and N. We're going to replace this with P. All right, again, we're going to bring everything down, and let's go back to our first step. Let's look for the logic gate that has the most brackets. In this case, it is the OR gate. So we'll draw the OR gate with the inputs M and P. All right, and as before, we're going to label it with Q. Let's bring down Q. Let's replace M or P with Q. And we'll go back to the first step and look for the logic gate that now has the most brackets around it. We now have 2 options, XOR and NOT. And as before, we're going to do the NOT gate. Again, just a stylistic tip is whenever you're joining lines, to draw a dot to show that they're joining. And since we've drawn our NOT gate, we're going to label it with R. And we'll replace NOT C with R. Let's again bring everything down. And we're left with 1 final logic gate, which is our XOR gate. The XOR inputs are Q and R, so let's draw it in the middle of these 2. Let's connect up our inputs, and finally we'll label it S. Let's replace Q, XOR, R with S. And finally we're left with X equals S. When x is equal to a single gate, we're going to join up the input from our gate to x, the output. And there we have it. Now, these labels can be used for the truth table for the next question and can be erased if you'd like. Otherwise, you won't get marked down if they're left on your logic circuit.